Hey, what's going on, guys? This is MBDC back with another video for you guys here today. And today, Supergirl is back in full effect. We're talking about that today. Don't want to miss the video. Click like, get subscribed, and stay tuned for the video because this was a good episode. And also, there's going to be spoilers in this video, so if you have not seen the episode, do not watch this video. But man, I'm jumping right into it. So this was a big Lex Luthor episode. And we get to meet him 4 years ago back in Metropolis. And he's talking about Superman and how he's not a man. And the world should have been looking up to him, looking up to Lex and not Superman. And he has like Lena strapped to some chair. And she's like, you're crazy, you're a psycho. Is it all about ego for you? And he's like, yes, like this, I am the man and he's not the man. And you see him blow up some cops, or you don't see it, but you hear it off screen. He blows up some cops in a helicopter. They finally come in, they take him down. So you see how he gets arrested, which I thought that was a nice touch because they didn't just talk about it through exposition. They actually showed him getting arrested, which was a nice touch. And then you get to present day, you get like the medical helicopter and stuff like that. You get Lex in the helicopter laid out. I guess he had a stroke, he's dying, he has cancer. You find out later on that through all his experiments with the kryptonite, that the kryptonite gave him cancer. And then Lena even makes a reference like, find it amusing, I see the irony of you need black kryptonite to heal you now. And so the whole episode is about that. So we get the fallout from James being shot from last episode, and then that's like the whole episode. We spend most of the episode in the hospital with James and the fallout from him being shot. Now how it affects people in different ways. Brandy thinks it's his fault. Dreamer thinks it's her fault because she couldn't see this in her dream. They end up kissing, by the way. That was like a very small nugget. And Brandy's like, we can't be together. He quotes Keanu Reeves. I thought that was pretty funny. Lex was a slow burn. He was in the wheelchair. He's trying to help Lena figure out the hair and nails, trying to help her figure out how to make the cure non-lethal. And they go back to the whole heart pumping thing like they did earlier in the season, how the hearts kept giving out or exploding or turning all black. But they finally got it to work, be 99%. Well, James's sister comes into the fold and she says her whole point in this episode was to make James go into surgery. And she says, yep, he's bleeding internally, going to surgery. Mid-surgery, the power goes out at the hospital. Lena comes in and basically they have to give him the cure, even though it's not 100%. They have to give him the cure. And it works. He's healed. He's cool. Remember I said in my last video, I was right about this, but I was wrong about something else. We'll get to that in a little bit. I do admit when I'm wrong about my predictions. Well, I was right that they would give James a cure. We don't see if he has any superpowers or if he's super because of it. But he is cured. I think that we will see the superness, the repercussions of him getting the hair and nail in future episodes. But yeah, Lex was a slow burn. Slow burn this whole episode. And man, was it worth it. The last like 10 minutes of Lex was awesome. Awesome. This episode's like made me feel like, okay, Supergirl's here. Like, dang, why didn't we get this earlier in the season? Like, Supergirl's finally here. It has arrived. Man, it makes everything we watched previously up until this point worth it. Now, if anybody was on the fence about John Cryer's Lex, even I was a little bit because I watch a lot of Two and a Half Men and like I can only see him as Alan, like Charlie's brother. But if you're on the fence about Lex, man, this episode should have changed your mind because it sure did change my mind. And he is Lex. That last 10 minutes, I was like, that's Lex right there. That is Lex. He was awesome. The whole thing. So you find out his whole plan. He had James shot, which I didn't see that coming. We know Miss Tessmacher shot him. Now, shout out to Matt because my boy Matt told me this and I was wrong. This is a prediction I was wrong about. I said Lena shot him, which was totally opposite. Miss Tessmacher shot him because she's been working for Lex the whole time. So she's been Lex's right hand on the outside the whole time. Remember earlier in the episode, he said he was pulling strings and she was a string puller apparently for Lex while he was in jail. And so we figure out Miss Tessmacher's working with them. We figure out that one of the brothers from earlier, I can't remember his name. I'll put him up on the screen. You guys know who he is. I'm the one who created Agent Liberty. It's been working with Lex. Lex gets the cure. So Lena's like, you're not getting the cure. You cut the power off to the hospital. You could have killed children. You could have killed James. You did this whole thing for me just to test the hair and nail cure because she didn't want to test it last episode. And this whole thing was planned out by Lex for her just to test it. And he goes, you missed one thing. I actually had him shot so that way you can test it. And so when he gets up out the chair, rips the thing off, he's in his Lex suit, and they walk out, and he's killing all the guards with his gadgets and stuff and blowing them up. I was like, dang, this is Lex. I was juiced about it. I don't know if you guys are juiced about it, but Lex is here. Looks like he might be working with Agent, Agent Liberty, but looks like he might be working with the Children of Liberty, and we're going to get more of that alien versus human type thing debate going on. But now we got Lex in the fold, so I'm not too mad about it now. Side story with John and Manchester. We didn't see the Elite. We just saw Manchester. I guess he got the staff of Ranmir, and he blew up John's father's grave. And so basically, they have a telepathic connection, and it's them going back and forth all episode. They finally meet at the dam. He stabs, he finally gets the staff, stabs Manchester. Manchester, like, explodes. And when John is in his true form, he says, like, you're so beautiful, I guess. It's like, you want him to show his true form and be an alien. Manchester's dead, I guess. I still don't know. This is two episodes in a row where he died. I still don't think Manchester's gone. I don't know. Maybe it's just the superhero TV show in me where it's like, somebody can be dead, but that don't mean they gone. And to quote Stephen Amell on that. But yeah, it's just like, I don't know if he's dead. Like I said, because we didn't get the Elite in this episode. So it was kind of weird. That whole scene was a little bit weird. Them and their struggle. We did get Brainy's Legion ring back, so that's good. We got his Legion ring back, so hopefully we get more of Manchester, because I do like him as a character, even though this episode, it just reminded me of Blade, for, I don't know, the trench coat, like, I don't know. Something like I was thinking, random, I know, but I was just thinking, I was like, man, he just reminds me of Blade for some reason right now, but yeah, that I hope we do get more Manchester. Do like Manchester a lot, but man, this episode was awesome. I don't care about the haters on Supergirl. Keep seeing Supergirl's getting canceled, but Supergirl's doing awesome. So leave a like, show your support for Supergirl, and tell me what you thought of this episode. Tell me what you thought of Lex, because Lex was dope. So let me know what you think. Again, do not forget to get subscribed, you know. And what I got next? Oh, I got Black Lightning. I think Black Lightning season finale, Arrow, and Flash coming up. So stay tuned for that. I'll definitely catch you guys in the next one. This is MBDC. Peace.